62 million children face conflict, disease, and other humanitarian crises. Each time you've heard from the launch of UNICEF Humanitarian Action for Children 2015 appeals in Geneva.
The biggest chunk of the money, nearly $1 billion, targets the deepening emergency in Syria and affected areas nearby. An additional $500 million will be used to scale up efforts to tackle the devastating Ebola epidemic in Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Guinea. The appeal will provide assistance to 98 million people in 71 countries. Two-thirds of the beneficiaries are children. UNICEF Director of Emergency Programs, Ashan Khan, said children are more at risk today than ever before from conflict, hunger, disease, and abuse.
One in 10 children around the world, 230 million, currently live in countries and areas that are affected by armed conflicts. And children are increasingly targets of war. Violently attacked at home, at school, in the streets, and used as weapons and force to fight around the world. The conflicts are no longer isolated to one country, and have spilled over to create crises in neighboring countries as well.
This can be seen in the Middle East. UNICEF pinpoints the Syrian conflict as the world's worst humanitarian crisis among the many tearing apart the lives of children and their families.
The agency reports 12.2 million people there are in need of humanitarian aid, including 5.6 million children in Syria and the neighboring countries. While the needs in this area are enormous, Khan says, UNICEF is also dealing with many other regional crises. We cannot ignore the needs of children in the Central African Republic, which equally has a knock-on effect on places like Chad and other neighboring countries. Nigeria, in Cameroon, each of those children should be given an opportunity to have a basic education, safe access to healthcare, clean water, and be protected.
Meanwhile, Ebola continues to take a heavy toll on children. UNICEF reports about 10,000 children in Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Guinea have lost one or both parents to the outbreak, and many are stigmatized and shunned by their communities. UNICEF Global Ebola Emergency Coordinator, Peter Salama, says it is important that these three countries are not forgotten as Ebola declines over the next few months.